Hi, I'm Anne-Marie from Brambleberry.com. Thanks so much for watching today's episode. Today's episode is a palm-free recipe that's also eco-friendly. In addition, we're using aloe vera concentrate to help make it extra skin-soothing. So why palm-free? Well, even though cosmetics use less than 3% of the total palm produced in the entire world, palm oil can still be an issue for orangutan habitat. And so many soap makers are choosing to go palm-free. Now, Brambleberry's palm oil is of course sourced sustainably, and we have the certifications to prove it. But if you don't want to use palm oil, this video is all about how not to use palm oil in your soap and some alternatives. So first things first, consider what you are removing from your bar when you don't use palm oil. Palm oil is traditionally a helper in the lathering capacity, and it also adds hardness and firmness to your soap recipe. The most common oil to replace palm oil with is Babassu, that is traditionally sourced in Brazil. It adds to the hardness and the firmness of the bar as well. Some other substitutions are things like lard and tallow, which are of course animal-based, but boy, do they create a very firm bar with tiny stable lather. Additionally, you can do a combination of butters. So like shea butter, cocoa butter, all of those butters do have a high percentage of firm oils or a firm component of oil in them. So those also add to the firmness of the bar. They don't help the lather all that much though. Other really good options include using up to 33% coconut oil in your recipe or olive oil pomace. Both of those will add to the hardness, and over time, that olive oil can really produce a beautiful lather. You could even soap super warm and add like a little bit of beeswax for firmness. Additionally, really keeping in mind that super fat, like what are you super fatting? What percentage are you super fatting? If you're super fatting too high, the soap's gonna be, well, not so lathery, and it's also gonna be soft. So keeping your super fat a little bit lower is really useful. So there's a lot of different things you can do to help make sure that your soap lathers really well and is firm if you're not using palm oil. A couple other ways to create firmness in your bars are sodium lactate. Sodium lactate is basically a salt, and it adds to the hardness in your bars. Additionally, you can water discount, and water discounting up to 15% can add to the hardness in your bar. And finally, if you're concerned about lather, you might try experimenting a little bit with honey or a little bit with sugars in your lye water, but not very much. A little bit goes a long way. If you're interested in learning more about how to formulate palm-free, we are tossing a whole bunch of links below. My soap book actually has 50% palm-free recipes. And of course, Brambleberry has a ton of palm-free recipes, and we've got a palm-free playlist as well at this channel. So my last two pieces of advice, if you're trying to soap without palm oil, is gel phase and pouring really thick. So a warm gel phase is going to make your soap harder, faster, and it's gonna give it a more even consistency. And the thicker you pour, the more hard your soap recipe will be right off the bat. So those are my last tips. And now I'm gonna show you how to make soap without palm oil and using aloe vera concentrate. Okay, sodium lactate's in the lye water, which I made ahead of time. And of course, this recipe's been fully weighed out. But the most important thing with soap making is always suiting up for safety. So preparation is one of the keys to making sure you always have a great soap experience. So, you know, laying out your oils ahead of time, weighing and measuring. But the thing that's gonna ruin your entire soap making experience and potentially cause like serious adverse conditions is not suiting up for safety. So that means gloves, long sleeves, pants, closed-toed shoes, and always, always, always goggles. And if you're really, really susceptible to lye fumes, a full face mask. We have great air ventilation. And of course, we don't have children or pets in this area. And I have a solid 1 hour to make this soap. But if that's not you, really consider what you need to make yourself feel safe and make sure you are safe when you are making soap. So one of the things that I'm using in this recipe to make it extra skin loving and extra soothing is aloe vera concentrate that, yes, comes from the aloe vera plant, and it's actually processed within a full 24 hours of picking it, meaning like from picking to processing to getting into containers to get to Brambleberry, it's just a 24 hour period. So this is fresh, herbaceous, and of course, skin loving and very soothing. It also, interestingly enough, has a very nice fresh smell. So you can either add it directly to your lye water, or you can add it at trace. I'm doing a full 1 ounce. I'm just gonna add it to my lye water right now. It is water soluble. Some people do like to add it at trace because they believe it preserves the skin loving properties of any extract or any additive, because at trace, most of the active lye, which is a high pH, we're talking above 14 or higher has been eaten up. It's been successfully neutralized by the oils that you're mixing it with. So that's why some people add their delicate extracts or concentrates at trace. In this case, I haven't noticed any difference in quality when adding before or after trace. So I'm just gonna go ahead and add it directly to my lye water that already has my sodium lactate in it. And here we go. Just such an interesting color because it gets, you know, kind of creamy. So Babassu oil is in here. Got a little bit of cocoa butter in here and olive oil and coconut. This is gonna be a very skin loving recipe that is hard with great lather, interestingly enough. That high percentage of coconut oil and the olive oil pomace is gonna give fantastic lather. I have my stick blender on low. I just don't wanna put too many bubbles in since I'm making this go through gel phase and I'm gonna pour it a pretty thick trace. Too many bubbles is gonna actually show in the actual finished bars if I have too many bubbles. So I just have this on low and I'm not using any fragrance. If you wanna use fragrance, of course, by all means go ahead. But since this is such an interesting recipe on its own, I think it's perfect to have no fragrance for. And let's see, so I'm just checking for trace. You know, I'm at a really nice, medium-ish trace. You could pour right now if you were doing swirling or something like that, but again, I'm trying to go for a hard bar and I want some designs, so I'm just gonna go ahead and do a little bit more stick blending. And I see those bubbles coming to the surface as I tap my stick blender. And again, I'm doing that because I just don't want bubbles in my final recipe, but it's not that big of a deal. Like, it's just an aesthetic thing. Ooh, cranking it. Whew. Now that is some beautiful soap. Gorgeous trace. I love a good, pure, simple soap. Ugh, so pretty. It's fun to do designs, but it's also really fun just to let the kind of glory and majesty of cold process soap making shine through with a very basic bar. And this is going to feel anything but basic once it gets on the skin. Lather is going to be great. It's going to be skin loving because of all of the good ingredients we have in it. Plus the addition of the aloe vera concentrate is really going to make this a beautiful bar of soap. This is a really nice trace. It's gorgeous. And I can tell it's going to go through gel phase. Can just play around with it. I'm gonna get a little spoon, play around with it even more. I do love to build up these little mounds though. I'm probably like a 2-year-old out of sandbox right now. So just a little bit of mounding here just to give it some interest. And then I can put this right onto a heat pad, and let this make sure it goes through gel phase, and then I'll be able to unmold in just 2 to 3 days. So if you're kind of like, what's a heat pad? This is literally the studio's heat pad. It's disgusting. It has soap all over it. I think it's used for like low back pain or something. So we just purchased it at a regular store, and you just literally put your soap on the heat pad, you crank the heat up, and then because your soap is out and exposed, you can actually see it going through gel phase, or if it's really cold, like say you soap in a garage in Minnesota in the winter, toss a box over this to help keep the heat in, but you can always, you know, cut a little hole in the box and check it to make sure it's going through gel phase, and you'll be able to actually physically see the gel phase approaching and getting to the surface. It gets gelatinous, and well, there's a reason we call it gel. Looks like gel. So I'm gonna let this sit on the heat pad on high for probably about like an hour-ish, and I'm just gonna watch it to make sure the gel phase goes pretty much almost all the way to the ends, and then I'm gonna pull it off the heat pad because I don't want to boil the soap underneath because that causes cracking in the top. So this soap was made just about 3 days ago. It does have a generous helping of sodium lactate. Using the Brambleberry silicone molds, of course, is key for easy release. So I'm just gonna pull gently away from the sides, break those airlocks, make sure that this will come out. This obviously went through a great gel phase. You can see it in the texture and the shininess. And I'm just pushing gently down, and I'm not gonna plop this right on the top because I don't wanna lose the texture. That came out really easily. And I can see based on the texture from the sides that this did go through a very solid gel phase, and I poured it because I can see because there's tiny little bubbles. And that's just where the soap was almost bubbling up, literally trying to get all of the excess bubbles from the stick blender up, and they got hardened right in there. So I can see that. And this looks great. So now what I'm gonna do is just give it a quick cut. So there's no fragrance in this. So just there's, and so there's really no smell either. It's very neutral. The cocoa butter did not actually really make this smell like cocoa butter. However, interestingly enough, it's probably psychosomatic, but I can totally smell the aloe vera concentrate, which gives it just a really nice hint of herbaceous greenness. One thing I'm really happy about is I can see that the gel phase went almost all the way through. Now, it doesn't matter if it doesn't go all the way through, but it gives it a much more even consistency and an even texture when it does go all the way through. And with a palm-free bar, gel phase is really important for the final hardness of the entire loaf or bar of soap. So like any cold process soap, these bars do need to sit for 4 to 6 weeks so they fully cure and fully get gentle before you give them away or sell them. I hope you enjoyed today's episode and learned something new. If you make this soap, or really any soap from this channel or any of our In the Studios at Brambleberry, make sure you hashtag it BrambleOn so we can see what you're making. You inspire me, you inspire the artisan community when you do that. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up below and make sure to subscribe to the channel so you're notified every single time that we come out with new videos. Until next time, happy soaping. Maybe you're crazy.
I think you're crazy.